passage here. Nice. Oh, it's another one of these sections. More ace piloting skills then. I'm pretty certain I'll finish this tonight. Because we've got one crystal to go. I don't think it's going to take more than 3 hours. That's my assumption. I could be completely wrong. Let's see. Fight. It's going to be interesting. Blue Rose attack. Ha! Tartarus on leaving the island may return to us again, or reveal its condition for joining. Of course. Typical. All I had to do was leave the island and he would join me when I go back up there. And he's a really handy crew member to have, because his crew commands he'll actually boost the entire attributes of the ship for one turn. Which can be very useful in a battle. This place is like amazing and shit. What the fuck? Dracor. Well, that's the first time I've seen that bloody thing. Oh, I'm gonna crush its face in. Death and it causes damage. Alright, let's see what happens. Ha! If it's just a miss, then that's a miss. But if it is because it's immune, it'll actually cause some sort of damage.
Move! Give me strength!
This mob is flipping. Ha ha! He's not immune!
An utter victory.
I managed to learn that spell from grinding as well. Oh, there's no map here, is there? Shoot. Thank you. just got max on that as well. Yeah, he's the only one that doesn't have max info. But fuck it, let's go green. Just to get rid of mobs in like 2 seconds. Unfortunately, it has not been very successful in fighting the tougher creatures. Are somewhat annoying because you're trying to navigate and keep in your mind the map you've been through. What the fuck is that thing? Shrill. Shrill? It's where the thing is green. Which are diametrically opposed. Thank you.
Over there.
So what I read, the next area we're going was that one I tried to enter earlier. If we go in there, we should be able to get the last couple of charms and unlock the ultimate weapon. I've been spacing out the JRPGs on my list so we don't get them bookending after another, because I know that can be quite boring for some people. And it'll be very boring for me. As much as I've enjoyed this game, I do want to move on to something else. So I'm pretty certain if I bookended stuff, it wouldn't go very well. See if this insta-kill
gives us strength.
It's kind of annoying with that bounty hunter. It works like that every time. Every time, one go and it works. Oh. I know you're not immune, but. Okay. You boosted him and then he ran away. It's always funny when you see the AI do that. They boost one team member and that team member runs away. And it's like, okay. That was a complete waste of a turn. Okay, I was meant to pick that up. Okay, I I didn't think that was something you could pick up, but there you go. Damage the plant slightly more, that's my name.
Over there!
Effect on her attack.
Let's try this.
Fun. to get back through this fucking tunnel. Judgment does. Huh. Oh, it's really a fairly powerful attack, seeing how much skill power it takes up. You see, there's loads in the air. Come on, there we go. Judgment!
Shall be swift and just.
Whoa, what the hell?
Now face your punishment.
Damn. That's fucking impressive.
That wasn't so bad.
Keep that ability in mind in the next boss fight. Hey, summon some sort of awesome dragon thing to come down and just beat the shit out of the enemy. Like the description of the spell of the ability says, he summons the person in the Colosseum to be judged for their actions. Yeah, it's definitely an ability we need to use against the boss. Fuck it, man.
Retreat!
Oh shit. I was hoping to run because these things are a pain in the ass to fight. Not because they're hard, but just... tedious, is the more appropriate word. Listening was zero, I got stuck on that bit at the end before the end of the stream. But I'll probably figure it out when I get back to it.
Move! Give me strength!
I should just remember it. Killed one. Steve, I added Army Men Sergeant Heroes on there, like you suggested.
That wasn't so bad.
Ah, see, After Survivors is Treasures of the Deep. Treasures of the Deep is a lot more of a chill game. I don't know if you ever heard of it. But yeah, I added that, I added that on there as a suggestion, and I've also, after Resident Evil Survivor is, okay, I can't pick up this crystal, whatever. After Survivor is Treasures of the Deep. And since Survivor is pretty much an hour of gameplay, we're probably going to move straight to the next game afterwards. It is a really fun game. You explore the oceans, as the title suggests, and you also get to rescue animals and things. It's pretty... And you get to kill pirates! So it's got a lot more action in it than it sounds. You actually get to kill pirates and shit. But yeah, you have to do other things to get money, such as rescuing animals by shooting nets at them, like sharks, what else, lobsters, oh no, lobster crab pots you get because you're stopping poachers. But there's also pirates under the sea that you get to blow the shit out of, so it's a bit of a weird mix. It's not, you know, some kind of 100% accurate, preservation simulator or anything. It also has some really nice music too, so it'll be really quite chill stream. That's what I predict anyway, because I saw somebody else streaming that game. And I was like, oh, I remember this game. Well, I only ever played the demo of it, but I remember it. I remember playing the demo of it and thinking, wow, this is really cool. Especially I think it's the boss in the first, one of the first levels. You have, the only way to get to the treasure is that there's a giant moray eel blocking it. When I mean giant, I mean a moray eel that's about as big as a ship. bigger than a lorry, which I'm pretty certain don't exist in real life. I know moray eels exist, but they don't get that big. But like I said, it's an interesting... I remember playing a demo anyway, and I remember being quite fond of it, with collecting treasures and such, and attacking pirates and that. I Bloody Vice is the one getting the bloody attack down. Play it, because I only ever play the demo, so I can't comment on what it's like later down the line. I just only know the limited amount of weapons you can take and the limited amount of missions. I mean, I might play it and there might be a bunch of shit, who knows? That's part of the fun of doing this, I find. Yeah, if you look it up yourself, you'll see for yourself. Yeah. Yep, one way to find out. But I do remember loving the demo and the idea of just like, you know, being permanently underwater and shooting people and stuff.
Here goes!
Tell me I've just gone full fucking circle. Or is this like into the center? Oh! Oh, it's into the center!